Right, I'm going to get this in the car, but I just want to vent for a minute. Allow me a minute to vent to South Tyneside Council. Now, morning again. Whoop. That's how bloody. That's me with me levelling me table. There's an increase like that of so many jobs I've got to get done in such a short time. The end goal is, there is another end goal. I seen Mark last night from the allotment. Now he's got some fancy Brussels sprouts that are going free. And you know what I mean? Freebie. I've got some beds. I'm going to put them in. But I've got so much to do before that. We'll start now and then we're good to go. This street, it's getting, as you can see, they're starting to come out. My wife's saying, are you going to empty that bloody bin? So I'm emptying this bin, but I'm going to say goodbye, and it's going the same way to me cucumber. You know me cucumber that Jessie said she did? I can't remember when we did it, in January or February. It's going the distance, but let's just get this sorted out first. I'm already on the first bin, it's all full already. Got it all in there, get it in. I'm gonna wash that out, but the cucumbers, it's looking a bit tired and a bit lost, and the other ones are gonna start coming into their own soon, hopefully. So, I don't want to clutter this little place now. Right, I'll put this down for safekeeping to wash. But this, do you know what I mean? It's not kind of doing much now. It's a little bit. Oh, there's bloody hell. Speak of the devil. One last one. The only little ones that come off it. But it's going. It's going. Right, I feel guilty now. Get out there. Get this and put this in the bin. So when did that? This was a Merlin F1, the 12th of the 1st. Man. I wouldn't say it's been prolific, but we've had about 9 little cucumbers off there, so. Come on, we'll all go and say goodbye. That's another job which I'm going to do straight away. Well, not the, I'm going to water them because they're looking hellish dry there, but they're ridiculous. I'm just going to transplant them ones and some of my other ones. There we go. Keep the pot, but she's in. She's in there, and it all helps for the garden. I'm just wanting some pots. Like I say, I'm going to be just making the ridiculous a little bit. Any more kind of that size pots. Yes. Are them all right? Are they a bit small? While I'm here, I just do them onions in one of my big trays. We'll see. I haven't got much left, to be honest. Actually, it wasn't ridiculous that I'm planting on, apart from these ones, because I haven't just sown mine. It's the pak choi that's going to go and get a little plant off. Right, there we go then. That's the pak choi done. Again, I'll put them down here and I'll water them. Right, I was looking for a tray, to be honest, but I'll just put these pak choi in them. What I'm hoping for is there's more than one. You know how you drop seeds in and there's a couple goes in, so I'm hoping you get more than just the 8. Well, that was money well spent. I've still got four, presumably four there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Then there's even littler ones here as well. So I probably don't even need the seeds I sown. So this is my last compost at the moment. God, I have to get some sorted out. Now I know it's not ideal, but the only pot I've got at the moment, I'm going to use these root trainer ones. And I'm just putting all them onions in. See how many I've got in here. To be honest, that was so good a value of money. There's me, ridiculous, still got them. I've planted all them onions there, and I've still got 1, 2, 3, 4 cubes of onions here. So I'm just gonna bung them in this big pot and then just let them bring on. And if I need them, I even just find somewhere to put them. You know, just so they're in some soil and they're kind of, I'm not just chucking them out. Look at all them, man. That's just bizarre. Yeah, I know, kind of, I grew the pak choi myself, but the amount you get, it's worth considering. I'm going to give them a water, then there's a big job. But these are one of the jobs that my wife's told us to kind of get done. I'll show you it. So, it's out here. I've been putting it off and putting it off, and it's been in the front garden for about a week and a half. Bloody thing here. It's an old thing that we had in a spare room that just held kind of old things. But I've got to go to the tip with it at 12:30. But I want to just get it in the car without smashing it up. So I might put these drawers in the back seat. I don't want crap all. Right, I'm going to get this in the car, but I just want to vent for a minute. Allow me a minute to vent to South Tyneside Council, right? So this is our house. You step outside, straight away, big sign outside my house. Keep, and I parked on it, mind you, keep clear, right? So that's for someone who lives about 300 yards down there. It's for them, their benefit, but me, like 2 foot away, keep clear. And why? Just to make it even more my house, it's got like a yellow line there as well. So next door, haven't got a yellow line. It starts at ours and goes up, and then it goes up actually double yellow lines. That's why I park on the back, because it's a nightmare to park here, because I keep clear. But when I'm loading, I do it, but... Right, come on, I've vented enough. I might have to break that big one down, actually. I think I am. I'm going to have to... Normally, I could get it in the car. Well, not normally, but I've got the professional dog bars in, and I don't like that they're in, so I kind of knock the right. Well, that actually, oh yeah, bastard. This is why I didn't want to do this, because it just takes too much time and hassle, but I'm in an eye now. Well, not bad. It took seconds. I've put that off and put that off and put that off. Every time I've come out, I've missed it, so you can't see it because it's just been standing there. The bloody allotment. 5 minutes, little sanctuary. So I was chatting with Mark yesterday, Mark who's got the allotment down there, and he mentioned he has some Long Island Brussels sprouts, some spare ones. Well, hey, so let's just get in. I mean, I've noticed that cardboard's not there. Just noticed that. So look at now, they've moved it there, so yeah, they want it. That's nice, to be honest. Right, I tell you what, normally we walk that way into the garden. This is the walk everybody else does. That's my own private gate. But this is the kind of the main walk through, which takes you to the path from this angle. Just have a little look at everyone's fleece. Remember I had bees swarming, they landed in there. memories. So we'll go down to Mark's because I want to show you something as well. Actually, one other thing. I want to show you the difference from tomatoes in pots with the holes. And Mark has a good example of this. He's got his friend who's having one of the greenhouses, which he showed us last night, where you've just got to keep water when you've got no holes in your pots. So Mark mentioned Long Island Brussels sprout. There they are, before the bloody birds get them. So I could take a few of them. I come back. But Mark said as well, over in there, he's got some comfrey in water and he says it stinks. Now I've never smelled it, to be honest. I have no idea what it smells like. So I thought, smell-o-vision, let's have a look at it, see what's going on. Ah, Mark's got these weeds as well. They're a right bugger to pull up. Do you know what I mean? And they're sharp grow. So somewhere in here must be these two buds here. Let's just have a little look. Try and get this lid off. Oh, that's terrible. Oh. So there's two buds, Mark's got that, of that comfrey. So if it works, you know, good on. But actually, let's show you Mark's. So Mark's greenhouse, well, he's got three greenhouses, but he let his mate have one. Now Mark does what, and like I say, I don't know if it's a northeast thing, but we do the plant pots with the holes cut in just like mine, sunk into the ground. So the roots, you aim there and you go in, you know, and the roots get into the ground. And Mark's plants just look as healthy as anything, to be honest. Now, Mark's mate has just got the plant pots. Although there's soil here, I'll just have a look. Can I sneak in? It might be actually locked. Just got the plant pots in. Now, we came up last night, they've been watered today. They were just like, and Mark says, you've got to be on the ball all the time because they're a big plant just in that pot. So, So if you're going to do pots with holes in is the way to go for an easier time. They'll still work, you'll still get tomatoes, but I need to get some of these. How many am I? I was thinking eight, you know. Yes, two, four. Mark said he's got, because I says, oh God, Mark, I don't want to take them, you know what I mean? But he says he's done a few, actual few patches of them. There, now that would be a nice bed, one of me beds. Eight, netted over, yes. I'm going to put them in this bed that I just cleared. I know I had brassicas in the other day, but I'm not even bothered about that. So I'm going to put them in there because I tell you why. I'll show you. It's a nice size for eight, but can you spot the main reason? The net's already there. Do you know what I mean? So just pull it over, plant them, feed them, that's it. Not the bonniest of netting, but you know what I mean? It'll do. Fed, watered. That's what should have happened. As soon as I pulled, and it's the old fella could have done it straight away to get it timed so your veg can go straight. I've had to kind of borrow it off a neighbour. Thank you, Mark. This show is dedicated to Mark. Thank you very much, lad. There we go then. Done. One bed taken care of for the second coming. And actually, I was talking to Mark about it. I might just use... We'll see how it goes. They might turn out better than mine. Is just for the Brussels sprout tops. Might be nice. Look after yourself. Take good care.